Be getting started in just a moment.
You were employed at the homecoming.
Okay, let's get started. That plan doesn't work. That's good. No.
Thank you.
Come on. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Thank you. give me a heart. Yeah. Oh. Mm. What the hell? Okay, no idea how that missed. Move too soon. Yes! Spit off, Lair. Ugh. Okay. Move less, then get the hearts. Ugh! Gotta get the hearts first. There we go. Jeez. take. On. Hey, Stewie, how are you? Yeah. I'm doing good, just thanks, Zapyro. How are you? On, quickly, quickly! Urgh! Yeah, you're well, that's good. Oh wait, that's yeah, I shouldn't have done that quite so quickly. Or quite so immediately, I should say. Okay, move quickly. Depends. I mean, PG-13 in America can be either PG or 14A here, so what we can get away with really depends. You might laugh, but it's a completely different rating system up here. Granted, the rating systems aren't always consistent. I mean, there's been some cases of R-rated movies getting the PG, R-rated American movies getting the PG rating. Of course, it's not always due to things like language or themes, sometimes it's just due to violence. I mean, a 14A movie, probably something with a lot of nudity and violence that isn't considered, I don't know what you'd call it, not tasteful, I don't know how to put it exactly. I mean, if we can get away with piss off at the G rating, I don't know. Wrong button. An example of an R-rated movie getting the PG rating up here would be Roman Polanski's Macbeth. I mean, Macbeth is already one of Shakespeare's most violent plays, so I guess it goes without saying that would get how do I even get down there? I guess it goes without saying that a specific play might get a higher rating in some countries. Yeah, being since we have a different definition of what's PG up here, I have to specify. Ugh! the hell? Son of a... How? I've done this before. Why am I having trouble now? Yeah, there we go. Yeah, Roman Polanski's Macbeth is good. In theory, the nudity is probably because the producer, the company funding it was Playboy. But don't quote me on that. I mean, the nudity is not excessive. I mean, there's a bizarre scene where witches are completely naked, but... Specify, two of the witches are women past 60, so it's not really fan service. Okay, let's see. Ah! There we go. And of course, the other case of nudity in that movie is the sleepwalking scene. In any other movie, Lady Macbeth would be completely dressed, but instead she's naked. Because why not? I mean, it's a good movie, but in theory, the nudity is only because Playboy was the one funding production. Yeah, the violence, probably because of Charles Manson's cult, killing Roman Polanski's wife and their unborn child. I mean, yeah, we're getting maybe some pretty dark territory in the explanation of that movie, but it's basically... The fact part is what Charles Manson's cult did. The theory is Playboy funding the movie. Another example of a PG movie up here that's R down in the States is Michael Mann's The Last of the Mohicans. It's not really, there's not any nudity in it, but it's basically on the violent scale. It's pretty interesting. Oh jeez, so busy talking, I didn't realize what I was supposed to do. I'll just say with The Last of the Mohicans, it's basically violence. Apparently, up here we're good with a guy getting impaled with a war club. Of course, I should go on record that specific version of The Last of the Mohicans isn't a straightforward adaptation. It's a remake of a previous one, and that death via impalement by War Club I mentioned was actually by drowning in the original film. I honestly think Michael Mann was just taking advantage that we're able to get away with more violent deaths these days, since a proper rating system was created. Since back in the 30s, it was just an office that decided what was acceptable and what was not. Okay, let's see. Mart. Ook! I'm sure I've mentioned this before, but I'm no good with heights. Wait, hold on. I think I see something down there. I guess that means we have to take the plunge after all, Wait, this isn't the... who am I kidding? Of course that wasn't the boss. Actually, while I'm there... while I can get back here... Come on, give me some hearts. How much farther do we have to go? This place goes on forever. There's no point in complaining about it. We must press onward. After all, how much more could there be? Come on, Alonso, let's go. Thank you. There we go. Ugh. Ouch. Took me less long to find one. Thank you. Got no arrows.
Hmm.
There we go. I'm guessing I'm getting close. What?
Thank you.
here. Excuse me. Corner in the hole in the center of the room, okay. This is not it. Hey, Steven. There we go. I do not have Stardew, Steven. Of course, you could always check my wish list if you don't know. But I do, and what I do and do not have. Jeez, what am I doing? It happens, Steven, it happens. A lagging stream is just something that happens. Yeah. I said I do not have Stardew Valley, but you can also always check my Steam wish list to see what is or is not on it. Because it is on there last time I checked. Of course, if you have Stardew Valley, you can always check to see which of your friends have it, has it. What the hell? Huh. Oh, yeah, of course. Thank you. Yeah, that's a good idea, Steven. I mean, a friend also got me Monster Prom recently, and that has a multiplayer feature. Oh jeez, where's that other one? Sam's giving you a bad time, ha 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 ha. Okay. That's all of them. Somewhere around here. There we go. Huh. It's fine. Jesus, this has to be the hardest dungeon in the game. Thus far. V8. What's a V8, Steven? The wall. Careful. Da-da-da-da. Huh. Wait, what? Hold on. Oh, okay. I've been dumb. I have been very dumb. Markiplier levels of idiocy. Of course, don't take that entirely seriously. In what meaning of the question, what else is new, Steven? Well, as I said, I got Monster Prom from a friend. ended up getting one of Miranda's secret endings first time I played it. There's a bunch of endings in that game. I'm currently reading the complete works of William Shakespeare. Have it with me right now. Well, if you're wondering which play I'm specifically reading, it's Antony and Cleopatra. How the hell do I, Well, my uncle and aunt and cousin are going to be staying for the long weekend, but frankly, I wish I was seeing them next fall. My family, my grandma, sort of, and by that I mean my paternal grandmother, because only in recent years have I realized just how bad she is, sort of. My maternal uncle, Joe, is temperamental. So I never know how his visits are gonna be. Bomb Atlas Switch. That could work. Great. Ah, good thinking, Steven. That's not a key. Even get in there. Wait, I've got the key. What did I say? That's not a key. Come on, give me a heart. can't really can't believe I did a 3.5 hour recording this morning. Let's play, of course. Cannot use the boots in combination with the cape. Closer before, why am I having trouble now? Yes, Steven, I certainly know how it feels when you are using the Elytra. No! Didn't mean to push that off. Yeah, that might be a good idea, Steven. I don't know why, but these really remind me of the mummies from the Turkish Star Wars. I'll send you some videos about that later, Steven. God, my leg. Everything's sitting cross-legged for 3.5 hours. It's bad, Yeah, look at it this way. I've been streaming since 105. So I've been spending a lot of my day cross-legged. There we go. What the? Hold on. And we continue. Ice, Brian, yeah. So, Steven, does your heart bleed for me? Okay, Asno, come on. Reserve the hall for Brian? Boy, I hope not. Wait. Damn! Thank you. Ugh! There we go. That's all for today. We'll go and give Mountain Dew Mania a raid. I'm Brian Croydragon signing out. Stay shrey!